Today I thought I'd try some picoCTF challenges. You know, I don't need the webshell. I can do it without webshell. Or maybe I can do it to use webshell some of them. So I already did a couple of them, but I'm going to start again. This is from 2024. I wonder where this challenge.zip is. It's probably on here already, but I can download it. Yeah, they had 7-zip installed on the webshell. There's a file there, flag.png. And if I remember correctly, it's a QR code, and you can read QR code using. Let's just try it. This program. Yeah, it was a QR code. And I already entered the flag here. Anyway, so if you open that PNG file, you can see that it's a QR code. Next one. Verify. Trick my players with invitation flags. Verify. No, I don't think I even have to launch the instance. Get that one, extract it. So, there are the files. Okay, there's a lot of files there. And what does decrypt do? It looks like it runs this open SSL command. And there's even the password here on each file. Most of them are not possible to decrypt. But one of them is possible to decrypt. That was 4F in files. Yeah, I wonder if I can write it like this. Instead of file name here, I'll just write $F, which is the name of the file in the for loop. I did 4F here. And then I can refer to it here in the command. So I can repeat this over and over again. Dump to end the loop. Now we will run this command. Okay. Do. I forgot the do. For semicolon do. Do. And open a cell command. Okay, I already saw something interesting there. There, one of the files decrypted. And the rest were just crap. Bad magic. So that's the flag, and I already entered it here for verify. It would be interesting to actually launch the instance, see what happens. But we already got the flag. Okay, so what again? Yeah, I already did this. Okay, that's not so interesting. Can I just close the instance? Now how do I get to the other ones? Maybe I have to close the webshell. Can I see? That's the question. to this computer here. Bluebeam walk on this one. See if there's something strange about it. It seems like it only has one JPEG file, unknown reality. And if I do some bin walk on this one, it's just a JPEG. Mm-hmm. Run strings on that. Okay, so this looks like a base 64 string, probably interesting. See if there's anything more interesting. This looks just like random binary data. I'll try the base 64 string here in the beginning. And there was the flag, and I already submitted that one too. Secret of the polyglot. I can, you know what, I can do it on the Mac. Okay, I cannot do it. I don't have been working on the Mac. Let's Linux box, run the inner walk. Now you could upload this to CyberChef too. Maybe I could try to upload it to CyberChef, because there's a PNG image and a PDF document. I can just open it to see the PNG image, or I can skip the first 914 bytes and then open it as a PDF document. But let's see what happens in CyberChef. I think this just runs totally in JavaScript. No. It's in TMP. Yeah, so, okay, it has already some letters of the flag, but not the entire thing. The PNG has this. Let's write it down. Speak fluent, and yeah, I can do it on this computer. No, I'm on the Linux computer, but I can't open the PDF over the Linux. Okay, let's do it here. What did I say? 914. Block size 1 byte. Skip 914 bytes. That is a PDF document. You're probably not just open PDF documents like this, but here is something which is probably the second part of the flag. Yeah, so that should be the entire flag. And I think I already submitted that one too. Yeah, but I wanted to do some extraction here. Extract files. Images, video, audio, okay, so here you can see immediately there's a PNG extracted there, there's a PDF extracted here. And now we can't actually see what's happening in the PDF. But if we open this as a PDF, we can see. The text is not in clear text in the PDF source. I think I can probably save this one download in desktop. Okay, put it in desktop. So I go to desktop. So that's the extracted file. So instead of DDI, I did to the cyber chef. Wonder how SSHFS works. Let's see if ChatGPT can answer me. Okay. I'll make a remote point first, we call it Kinanon. That's the name of the remote Linux computer. Over SSH, the Linux computer from the Mac computer. So, for instance, in here, see the polyglot. There was a flag. There it is. The same as I wrote. Okay, this should make it simpler to go back and forth. Clear the receiver, I can keep that open. Maybe I can try to not to the flag. You saw this challenge again. Now Mob Psycho, that was the Android one. And since I already solved this, I think I remember where the flag is. Mob Psycho. This is an APK in Android. Application, and it can be extracted with 7-zip, X for extract, and somewhere here is a flag. So here is a file called a flag, that looks like a flag in hex encoded, ASCII. Let's go to Cyber Chef. Enter it. There are many ways to do it. You can, for instance, use XXD, which comes with Vim. But I'm going to try to use this instead. Hex, XXX, something. From Hex, maybe. Yeah, and here's the flag. Now I have NDNS. It organizes bytes in a weird way. Let's download it. It's just data. So if you see the first magic header here, FFD8 is a known magic header of JPEG, I think. So those, I can ask this magic script. FFD8FF. So FFD8FF. I think I just reverse the first 4 bytes, 32 bits. Reverse it. Okay, so how can I do that? Let's see if that one, ChatGPT, conv swap. Okay, that's I don't think that works. Let's try. So it switched every 2 bytes, but I want to reverse each 8 bytes. What's that? 3210. Said okay. do you think this works? Let's see what that does. Let's see first. Okay, that printed out 1 to each 4 bytes. Actually, that's a good start. Anyway, yeah, I can just reverse each line. Yeah, FFD8FFE0. Yeah, that looks good. I can just reverse each line. Characters. Characters. Rev, okay. Okay, that was actually correct. Good. And then I want to remove new lines. You get one long hex string and convert back to binary. Ah, mama. Okay, that was not correct. FF, delta, FF, no, E. Ah, okay. It reversed. I should just FF8D. It should be FFD8. Yeah, I should just reverse the bytes, not every character in the hex. Okay, let's try this one. Yeah. I really don't think this will work, but you never know. Just take it one step at a time and see what happens. Yeah, this is correct. Okay. Remove new lines. Convert binary. Okay, now it's a JPEG file. You can just move it. Okay, so that's the flag. Okay, I don't feel like entering that whole thing. Certified Indian, sorry, Indian. Okay. Convert. Yeah, that's not correct. But I can correct it while I enter the flag. First of all, it should be curly braces, yeah. Let's see. Curly in lodges. Certified. Okay, sorry. Indian. No space there. 6 yeah, no fanfare. Yeah, that might work. So yeah, anything. Okay, subspace here too. Yeah, that was correct. Okay, so now that's the two hard ones left. Blast it from the positive. Oh, yeah. Set timestamps. You know, this one is. You can check with. Some tool to check all the metadata. Okay, let's download the image first. Use this picture. the original, I should not touch the original. Check metadata on the PDF file. Okay, let's give it a command line. Yep, ChatGPT. Exit tool. I don't know. I don't have that installed. Yeah, I have it installed. So it has some stuff here. And it asked me to change some of this metadata. To 1970-01-01-00-001. So I think this 703 should be changed to 01-001. Date here, so these are in ASCII, so this could just be changed to the date we want the date. To this. Needs to be changed, and this 703 also needs to be changed to 001. This will be 000, and this should be 1970-01-01. There's a number of places. Still has 703 and it's not yet work. It did change this date. It did not change this 7373. Did change those states there. And it did change the modified date. Okay. Yeah, we can go on and change things here, but I'm going to do the other one first. Because I think this exit tool actually removes some data, so you have to check the diff in the hex map between those two files. Enter it manually in the first file with the hex edit or something. And then launch the instance, check the image and see what it complains about until you get everything right. But I'm going to do that one first, because that's more fun. Download this image. I actually did this one, but not as this user. So if you think I'm cheating, I'm kind of cheating. I can do it in the web shell. Okay, I don't remember my password. Let's do it on the Linux computer. Your diary. Alright, let's do it in work first. Okay, I did it. No, this is going slow. I'm going to power it here. VPN tunnel over to this computer is very slow. So I run wget here on this computer. So run binwalk. I think let's just unzip it. We're working on that one. Clean file system. Okay, this takes some time. Okay, so that one actually, it has three partitions. And you can actually ignore the everything except this partition. Let's see if ChatGPT can help me. Okay, block size 1. This is clearly visible by. No, what I can do, I can actually factor it. So I can see what's visible by. Lots of 2s. And what do we have here? Okay, let's take 10 or 11. Okay, let's do it in 4096. Take this number, divided by 4096, it is even visible. I get this many 4086 sites, 4096 site blocks. Yeah, don't I have it? There. No. Skip. I skip these many blocks to only get the last petition. Nikama. Disk 3 image. If I counted correctly, it should be an X4 file system, and it is. I can actually try to mount it, but I want to first make a copy. I can also try to unzip it with 7-zip. Make a mount point. Can't read Superblock. Yeah, that's exactly how I wrote it. Can't read Superblock. Okay, this is a book. This is the 7-piton packet. So they created everything here. Okay. So the interesting thing should be root and home. Nothing in home, so it's in root. It's an ash history file, and it runs some force wait script. It's something here. Force wait, what does that do? Not much. It's all in the name. Okay, innocuous file. So, it's a Dear Diary, so it's probably something with a journal. Let's inspect the journal. Yeah, so I already know that it's something with a journal and something with the journal's copy of older versions of this file, because now it's empty. But if previously it had some information, so I had to extract that information from the journal. I can work on the copy. JLS copy, see what that says. So JLS, it's part of Sleuthkit. Let's see what it does. List the records and entries in the file system journal. It will use the default location, okay? So if I'm not interested in all this unallocated FS block unknown entries, I can filter them away. Okay, so I have some blocks that are not unallocated, so the information is probably in some of these blocks. What was the actual output of this? Just to pipe less here. Superblock seems to be innocent. It found it. So in okay, so all these are allocated blocks. Now I don't know actually. This works. Is this the block number, maybe? Okay, I'm just interested in things that are allocated. Okay, that looks better. So these are the blocks that are interesting to look at. So it's pretty large number of blocks, but I should search for innocuous. So how does J... So I got... Journal block number and description. Okay. And how does JCut work? Shows the contents of a block in the file system journal. Image. Okay, so let's just dump a block. Let's first dump the block numbers into a file. Yeah, that's just the block numbers, blocks. And then let's just test this out on the first block, 8 and 11. So something happened. I can actually do a for loop. B in $B okay, so I'm just all .bin files here are extracted information of the blocks that were listed as allocated by JLS. So I can for instance just string okay, so grep and a few lines after. Maybe a few more lines after. So I'm interested to see if I see something that looks like a flag or part of a flag here in the output. It's all in the name. It's these files, okay. You can just hex dump them one after another. 20.1. Force weight. Not this file. Okay, not so much there. Next one, 20.39. Okay, so here's part of a flag. Let's copy that. I should do the script. Pipe. Arc. Flagblocks.txt, so I can loop over them. 4B in peak OCT, this next one. F, start curl braces. That looks like part of a flag. That might be part of a flag. Thank you. looks like at the end of the flag. And this actually looks like a flag now. I see names. Okay, so now it's just blast from the past and left, and it's just manual work to trying to change all the fields. But just a hint is when you run exif tool, it will remove some things. So just believe me, exif tool, when you try to change the date, it will remove some field. So run exif tool to change the date, then hex dump both the original and the modified file, see what was different, and then go back to the original file and see what fields were removed, when you compare what fields were removed by exif tool, and then go in and manually change those fields until the data is correct. So for instance, that 703, that should be 001, and so on. Yeah, that's enough.